I was thumbing a ride one Saturday morning out of Nashville, toting my sack. I lent my car to a gal that lived in Chattanooga, and she hadn't ever brought it back. She was drinking pretty heavy when I let her have it. I hope she knows it was only a loan. There ain't no telling what I might have told her back at the time, but that old car was also my home. About 5 miles out, I was getting kind of tired, sweating hard, and feeling kind of weak. I woke up with no cigarettes or nothing to drink, and I hadn't had a bite to eat. My nerves were so quick I couldn't tell where I was shaking, then a set of brakes sang my song. Some fella stuck his head out of 57 Chevy and hollered, "Hey man, come on." I told him I was headed down to Chattanooga. They said, "Hop in, we're going there too." And the way they took off in a cloud of smoke, I still ain't believing it was true. They had the windows down and I was sitting in the back with my tongue still hung in my throat. He was hitting just about 110 and he said, "Man, what do you think of this boat?" Well, there was two semis struggling up ahead, one trying to pass the other. They had the whole road blocked, so he passed them on the right. And let me tell you something, brother. I was so nervous that my teeth was clicking. There wasn't no way my head could think. Then the one that was sitting on the passenger side turned and said, "Hey, man, you want something to drink?" I just shook my head because I couldn't talk. He said, "Okay," and then he said, "Cheers." Them fools was drinking whiskey and wine and chasing it down with beer. Well, I started sweating that old sticky sweat, and I know I was white as a sheet. Then one turned the radio on wide open and said, "Hey man, check that beat." By the time we reached the top of Mont Eagle, I thought I heard a rumbling sound. And then I saw a sign that said Fallen Rock, and right there I was floorboard bound. I was rolling and squirming on the old floorboard, too weak to set or stand. And then the driver said, "We're doing 120. Look here, man, no hands." I got up enough nerve to raise up and look, and by now there couldn't be no surprise. But his hair was blowing all over my face and dandruff blowed in both eyes. He never did drive on the right or left. He just kept on riding that line. I rubbed my eyes and saw the prettiest thing, the Chattanooga City Limits sign. He slowed down and I said, "Mister, please, I'd like to get off right here." He said, "All right, on into town with us. We're gonna go down and pick up some more beer." I said, "Please," once more, and he stopped the car and then he handed me my sack. Said they'd look for me on the road later on in case I wanted to catch a ride back. I got out and sat down by the side of the road feeling sick and looking mighty pale. I don't remember anything much after that, but next morning I woke up in jail. I didn't know anybody in my cell and didn't want to ask why I was there, but they all kept grinning and turning their heads and it was more than my head could bear. So I called the jailer and asked him to tell me why I was there if he'd be so kind. He said, "For stopping the traffic while I was hugging and kissing the Chattanooga City Limits sign."